synchronized swimming competition in the second of three tests that'll determine the winner. Today, it's the figures competition that'll count for 50% of the duet and solo score and will be used to determine the top eight qualifiers for tomorrow's round. And here are the standings after the first round. Leading the competition is Candy Costi and Tracy Ruiz. Tracy Ruiz today is expected to win this competition. Her figure score will be added to her partner's score for the final today. In second place, just behind the United States, are the Canadians. In third place, the team from Japan. In fourth place, the team from Great Britain. And in fifth place, the team from Switzerland. In sixth place, the team from Holland. And seventh and eighth are from France and Mexico City. Hello, I'm Donna DeVerona, and today the judges will be looking at six figures. These figures were only picked out of a hat, on the 5th of August. This is a procedure used by the officials here. There are 36 figures available to these athletes during Olympic time, the 4 years in between Olympics. These figures are established every 4 years, and then during a competition, the judges pick out six. With me to explain further and in detail this process is our expert, Esther Williams. What will the judges be looking for today, and how will these athletes perform?
Well, today the focus will be on technique. Skill, of course, just as in the duet competition, but more no frills today at all, just skill alone. What we have is no music. We don't have a girl with her partner. She is alone out there doing those figures. No costuming. Personality doesn't count at all. What you need is a tank suit, a white bathing cap, a pair of goggles, and it's all business. This is the nuts and bolts of synchronized swimming.
So we're going back to the basics today in six categories, and here they are. This is what the judges will be looking at. They'll be looking at the Eiffel Walk, the Kip Continuous Spin, the Ballet Leg Single Submarine, the High Tower, the Dolphin Foot First Full Twist, and the Aurora. And this is Tracy Ruiz from the United States, Candy Costi, her partner. They're leading the competition as they come into the figures. For Tracy Ruiz, an important moment because she is our U.S. entry for the solo competition, which was added after the Soviet Union announced the boycott. This score will count for 50% of her solo total score as well as the duet score. She competes individually here. Her teammate will do the same, and their individual scores will be totaled together for the score as they go to the finals in the duet competition.
Donna, what the judges are looking for in these figures is that they shall be performed very slowly, high and controlled. Get as much of the body out of the water as possible. And with each section of the figure clearly defined and in uniform motion, she must perform her figure in relatively stationary positions. She's very high out of the water. That's good height. And now she goes into a split position, holds it steady as you go, the other leg coming up, a perfect crane. One foot joining the other. She must scull very carefully not to splash. And out of the figure in a back layout position.
Tracy Ruiz, she has two competitions to be concerned about here, in the duet and the solo. And from Canada, this is 21-year-old Sharon Hambrook, a massage therapist. She is a member of the duet team that won the World Championship in Guayaquil, Ecuador in 1982, defeating Candy Costi and Tracy Ruiz. The Canadian team is only 0.6 of a point behind the United States in this duet competition, and if they're going to make up points, this is the place to do it in the figures.
This figure, Donna, is a dolphin foot first full twist. Has a difficulty degree of 1.7. Now she is going around in a circle, possibly 8 feet, depending upon her height. She straightens to a vertical, and now she rises until a water level is established between the ankle and the hip. And now we will see her execute a full twist, controlled, perfect timing, She bobbled just a little there. Who could have done without that? Now the body sinks to the depth at which the body was straightened to that vertical. The dolphin foot first continues until the body assumes a back layout position. She sculls herself into that back layout position. Those hand movements are very important. She had a nice, slow, and constant speed. She'll get points for that. Sharon Hambrick from Canada, her teammate, Kelly Crisper, there in second place, trailing the United States by only 6/10 of a point.
It's really remarkable, isn't it, what they can do in a pool? We'll keep you up to date, of course, this afternoon on the performances in synchronized swimming. But let's go now and find out about the controversy involving Dan Gable.